Bit of a shake and bake right here off the screen. You can't come out like that if you're Atkins and stand up offensively. Dexter Strickland with the ability to break it down with that quick crossover. And every time I watch this team play,
it's North Carolina's ACC home opener, and the students are back in town, but they'll try to avoid a hurricane.
Iowa. Well, Marcus Page is more of a scoring point guard. Left the floor in order to make that pass. Just a really nice cut by P.J. Hairston along the baseline right behind the defense and Ryan Brown. Front, that's where he can use his quickness, and you go under a ball screen. Marcus Page, the scorer, makes you pay.
He looked at his defender, Kaji, and he's feeling very, very... Simmons is open, and he knocks it down.
Simmons just comes out to the perimeter being guarded by Gamble, who would rather be down low and
for some help.
Nice pass.
Bullock there. And got it, the three-pointer. Timeout. Carolina, long distance, opens up a six-point lead. We welcome it back to North Carolina. Reggie Bullock, who's hit 49% beyond the three-point line, finds himself wide open and money. He's been doing that all season long. Carolina's made 4 out of 6.
When they could get out and run, you got to grind it out in the half court against this big, strong Miami team. That's not where North Carolina wants to be. They want to be in the open floor, and Reggie Bullock had a terrific first half. He had 9 points, went 3 of 5 from three-point range, and here's Marcus Page, the freshman point guard, the lefty. His head was up, vision great. The cross-court pass with that left hand. He had 4 assists.
This save, did he have a foot on that line? Tough to tell from that angle, but he wants to drive it and blocked out of the sky. Tremendous defensive play by Hairston to stay with him and not foul him.
And Hairston blocked that. That looked like a volleyball spike. A little bit of contact, but what a tremendous...
McAdoo with a sweet jump shot, but too long. Oh, stuffed in out of the sky by Tocato. Half a dozen. Page. Oh, and the basket as well as Johnson stuffs it down. Tremendous bounce pass. Page has made a couple of velvety passes tonight that'll really knock his socks off.
Well, he stayed low. Got in traffic. Instead of standing up, he stayed low and was able to thread that needle. That was a terrific catch and finish by Johnson. Got bumped there and nobody called it. Bryce Johnson gave him his backside, then helps as Shane Larkin was trailing, and Bullock very intelligently reads the double team and is able.
That has been so crucial to Carolina's success over the year. He is a guy who likes to face up, but his
need to go in the opening half. Hairston getting his own shot. He drains it. A three-pointer.
Point edge, and you like your disposition to start, Mr. Hairston. A little bit inconsistent, but a couple of threes has North Carolina.
I mean that baseline. Oh, nifty feed, and McAdoo with the stuff. How about that blind pass? We came to smash, smash.
If you're North Carolina, you're looking for somebody to take the reins offensively. And luckily for them in the first half, P.J. Hairston on the drag screen separates to the other side. This one, he's just sitting on the left-hand side of the floor, staying spaced. He gave them a lift. He had new roles.
Well, a nice give-off and a slam down by Hubert, who has...
couple, Mr. Hubert. I have a feeling this will not be the last time he's nominated.
He's stuck it. Over the top of the slam by McAdoo. On the alley-oop, perfectly run by Carolina. Buzzer. The dump down low, Hubert again. He's really getting involved.
Well,
Hairston on the attack, slams it down. Boy, another magnificent dunk in this game.
They are 7, and we have seen them finish in the paint consistently here. Mr. Hairston, he had 11 points. He's now got 19, and it felt like in the first half he buoyed them. A little sidestep dribble here to get an opportunity from three. This one was just spaced. That was in the first half. Does a nice job. This was the strong second half drive with authority. Boy, when you want to...
Hairston with his 19 on the drive with a stop. Man, has he had a day.
Yeah.
The lock. Simmons with a rebound, and that rolls in.
Absolutely killing him on it. The only guy delivering in the first half had 11 big points. How about that with authority? The quality of shots you need to have to win games, the competitive toughness to finish possession ball games. And Jackson Simmons, remember the last offensive rebound they got? It was because he kept the ball alive. This time...
Simmons will hand it back for Hairston. There's a career-high 21. Going to add to that. Yes! A two-pointer.
You see all the people wearing the blue, the tradition, the history that the people make the players feel. You know, when you run through the tunnel and you hear the noise, and it's a thrill for me to walk through that tunnel. If I ever come to
North Carolina, defending their home court against the Maryland team, coming off an upset over NC State on Wednesday. And the dozens and dozens of banners high in the rafters here at the Smith Center, the hallmark of college basketball royalty, Royal Carolina Blue, if you will, rows of legends, legendary teams, never to be forgotten. The students are ready to go.
David quickly on the other end. That was Hubert getting high up there to deny the layup.
Well, there's just so many things that Roy Williams has got to like to the start. Tracking you down in transition, getting out and playing Carolina basketball in the open floor, attacking the rim. And what do you know?
For the Terps, here's Bullock again. How about that start? Maryland just got punched in the mouth.
Young team coming off a big win into a storied building and not responding well. If you're Carolina, you are trying to avoid what happened after UNLV, where you lose your first two ACC. Roy Williams said urgency. He talked about getting out in transition, playing Carolina basketball. They are defending and running, staples of the
program. On the door, the top 25 after their win the other day. Bullock on a tough drive for two. Off to a great start. Give him 11. Run Strickland down the lane, a foul as well.
Carolina's best teams get you on their heels. Their transition is blazing, and the lead reflects it. Go either way and trying to provide a little bit of extra incentive off the block. You go out in transition, change ends so quickly. Opening tip, I mean, North Carolina's energy and effort and focus. And Roy Williams told us earlier today, any 50-50 balls when we by Roy Williams this offseason to round out his game. You've always known the three-pointer has been there, but get in transition. This guy can flat shoot the basketball, but when he attacks the rim, he keeps you off balance, and Carolina into the energy and effort. Remember, they'll scramble trap. I think that Carolina, who normally presses more and traps more when they're behind, senses that this is a shaken team, and they're trying to get some more separation. And boy, the more experience he gets, the longer those stretches are going to be. Out in the passing lane at 6'9". Can I handle the ball? You bet I can. I'm going right at the body of the defender. Up. Talented a player, as you'll see in college basketball. Basketball. That's a pro move right there. He's got length in his face.
Another stop. Strickland slams it down. And the heave will not go. And everybody up and out of their seats here at Chapel Hill. Maryland, that last turnover was their 15th of the half. Reggie Bullock shot the lights out, and Strickland with the cherry on top makes it 42-20. North Carolina, UPS halftime report.
From Mark Turgeon, boy, it's been so difficult. They give up a trans he could be disappointed in. You know, the effort on the glass or the ability of time to work with. Keep getting stops. Nope.
That's how you answer. Allen bouncing it. And denied by Jackson. Tremendous play.
Maryland's been trying to make a run, but met at the rim and denied a stand by North Carolina. They've got 6:47.
Round the back page twice and draws the foul.
Wow. Okay. He made it look easy. That, folks, is difficult. This is a guy who has worked on his handle, because what he just did between bodies is not easy. Once, twice.
Wow.
That is big time.
Fouls.
Shot left. How about the pass? Your defender is reacting. Go dunk that thing. Now he's got great hands. Then his scoring, and you're right. I mean, he has. He just gets great low post position. How about the crossover to shake Seth Allen, the hang in the air, and you've got your defender. Reggie Bullock was outstanding in the first half, but as you have noted throughout the course of the second 20 minutes, there's been long stretches where he's been the most dominant player on the floor. Defensively, he's got the ability to get passing lanes. He goes right to the rim. He has got a dynamite first step on a drive to the right hand. He does have some of this. He does have some low back.
Say goodbye from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Quite a day for the Tar Heels. They come out in great form, and they win by 10. Let's go back to the studio and Chris Cotter. A symbol of college basketball success. National title trophies on display and banners hung from the rafters have become an annual expectation of the North Carolina program. However, this season has been trying at times, and Tobacco Road had begun to wonder if this year's Tar Heel team is a bust. But after two straight ACC wins, the dark cloud has been lifted. And tonight, the Heels, so it's looking to upend the Tar Heels, who are getting on a bit of a roll now at back-to-back conference victories. Great to have you. James on the baseline. Nice pass there for Harrison. Great vision by the freshman to go in a half.
Well, one of the things the guards do incredibly well for Carolina is rebound the ball. They've also got to be here on assistance. Joel James gets a good look at the
dribble. Harrison catches, fires, drains it. A three-pointer on target. 6.5.
Well, Marcus Page playing faster and faster, and P.J. Harrison sprints up the floor in transition, stays spaced.
Strickland on that baseline. Back to McAdoo for the slam. And a timeout, Georgia Tech. James Michael McAdoo stuffing it down, and everybody excited here.
That's amazing. When you play hard defensively and share the basketball, good things happen. You know Strickland's a driver. He's not the shooter the other two guards are, and McAdoo, no doubt.
The spin move by Poole. He's denied. Page comes out of there with it. Strickland ahead of the pack. He attacks and leaves it in.
In on the defensive end, okay? We saw him hedge out in a trap and cause a tie-up. This time he comes over in rotation, blocks a shot, and it triggers a transition. And boy, do they change it.
What you were talking about?
Well, two freshmen working against each other, just squares up, pulls the trigger.
Got it too hard. Tokoto with the catch. The spin, took a little bump. Off the window for two. Boy, that's pretty.
As you said, Carolina, so many options. James Michael McAdoo, their leading scorer, just under 15 a game with 8 boards. Bullock is the best three-point shooter in the ACC, 47%. And this is their wild card. If P.J. Harrison
play.
Gets off his feet quickly, working the weak side of the glass, ball comes loose, just goes higher than everybody else, and an easy opportunity. Actually put a smile on his face after he made that bucket.
Bullock throw right away to Page, and now they've got numbers 3-on-1. Bullock bouncing to Page, back to Bullock, he lays it in.
It happened last week in Duke, happening here again to Georgia Tech. Right out of the gates to start the second half, Carolina putting on a spurt, getting out transition, easy opportunities, field goal for.
He will sit for a while. Here's Harrison into the flow with a three-pointer. He's into double figures. 10 and counting. And in McAdoo, and he draws the foul as well. He'll go to the line for a three-point play.
Well, you see what the level of athleticism. He's got the handle, you know, the push ahead, the ability to use the bounce, if only for one dribble, to give yourself a little strength and assertiveness going to the rim.
Without him, in transition, Strickland gets it off the slam. Oh, my! P.J. Harrison. He rocks the Smith Center.
I believe there's something better than this tonight. The steal. Two guys in the open floor. Carolina at its best. Look at that. Let's just listen to the authority with which he finishes this.
That's what I call finishing. That is a first-rate job of finishing that score. Yikes, and that's up against the guy right in his face who's about 6'11".
That is with the kind of strength and authority.
Let it go.
That play is a case in point.
This and the stuff as he followed it.
And then one of the elite athletes, he might just be a freshman, but man, can toe-to-toe. 15 points off turnovers by Carolina, 15-4 advantage, two-on-one situation. We just cannot get enough. This is the perfect play on the perfect dunk. I mean, how good is that?
That was, what,
too deep for me, but I do know we've got...
Hitting back-to-back threes, and they've cut a 28-point deficit to...
...games that you thought were over. There's Harrison shooting that three. Great screen to get him free for that three.
I'll tell you, State may win it, but Mark Gottfried is an unhappy man right now.
And they have just taken it up another level here at the end of the game. This baby looks like it's in. And there's the good offensive rebound.
In transition, unable to get back and cover the shooters. Again, when your star player gets the officials.
Hairston, heat check. Got another one. It's a third three and a half for P.J. Hairston. Carolina's doing it behind the arc tonight. They're shooting more threes in nearly 20 attempts a game than any season under Roy Williams.
And one of the big reasons why is, again, they don't have a polished, sophisticated inside game. So they have to find their points where they are. And certainly look at Odio driving. And a nice job, actually, a nice job by Bryce Johnson. And then in trend, it was a reach. And the reach obviously created enough contact to knock Jackson off his pins and lead to a Carolina layup. And the point that you're making, see, there's a reach right there. That was definitely a foul. They missed it. So. It won't be the last that any of these officials or any of turnovers more than anything else. You know, a team that doesn't normally turn it over an awful lot.
For now, remember, this is a North Carolina team, and now McAdoo with the reverse jam. Page for three. Oh, got it!
Big
wow,
shot.
A clutch triple from Marcus Page. Freshman from Marion, Iowa. Marcus Page stepping up and draining a clutch three.
A minute in those several possessions is what Boston College lost.
Sideways, you can barely see him, but he is a guy with a lot of offensive skills on the inside, and that was just quickness right there. You can't go for the steal against him. You have to. Strickland
banks it in, and he's fouled. It's a one-point game.
Kadarian Raines is not really a guy you want handling the ball out of the perimeter. He's trying to throw it to Green, tipped away by Strickland. And North Carolina has done a very nice job here the last few possessions, getting out in transition. Virginia Tech just can't get there.
Bullock back to Page for three. Yes. McAdoo is fouled. He'll go to the line for one more.
McAdoo does that so well. His ability to anticipate on the defensive end. That's now three fouls on Barksdale, who's lucky he didn't get a flagrant one called on him. But this is just a great play by McAdoo. Sees it coming, takes it, and then is very strong going to the basket. Going to get the opportunity.
And a great athlete. Bullock for three.
Oh, what a follow by McAdoo.
A little bit of a battle right now. Back and forth they go. Here's Bullock, looks for three. That's a long
bounce.
Pocket. Mainly because Bullock buries the three ball. James Michael McAdoo. Boy, what a performance he has put on here in the second half and throughout this ball game.
Timmy's ball goes inside. Here's the jump shot by McAdoo. He's made most of those today, but again.
Correction, that's on Sadarian Raines, and that's why it is the fourth person.
Right.
Page looks at a three. Bullock with the follow.
Talked all game long about North Carolina and working the offensive boards, and Reggie Bullock was not under the basket to start with. As that shot ran up, he just ran out from the three-point line to the basket. Nobody blocks him out, and he's able to score. For each team, James Michael McAdoo and Eric Green, and neither one of them have disappointed today. McAdoo has done very well. You see an offensive rebound there, a drive to the basket in transition, and he's been very good with that jump shot. North Carolina getting the overtime started the way they played most of the second half.
15, Page from beyond the arc.
Yes! Carolina's largest lead.
And it's been a long drought at the end of regulation.
And Marcus Page, he's found his three-point stroke today. That is his firepower.
He's red hot! Marcus Page for the two ball.
Ball game is McAdoo, but he does a nice job releasing the ball before they can get there to foul him, and then Carolina runs the fast circles around North Carolina because he just hasn't played as well as the expectations were for him, even though they may have been quite unreasonable. But he scored 19 points. He hit four big three-point baskets. He scored 8 of his points in overtime. He had 5 assists. And so he played a very good all-around game, and some of the shots that he made I thought were very
best shooter on this team. Double figures in 16 of 20 play. But you take a look there, you can't do any better defense.
Be enough for just one or two guys. Now McAdoo doing it all for Carolina.
Now they just got beat down the floor that time. If that's something that a coach just can't countenance. He's subbing right now, recognizing guys may be tired. But Carolina just beat Wake down the floor. Look at the guys huffing and puffing and chugging. You know, when you kind of make that kind of foul, you know you're too late down and running at a fast pace. They love that.
Pushing. Page in traffic. And it rolls home for the freshman. Like driving down Franklin Street Saturday night about 1 a.m. Page wasn't deterred.
And nobody gets in front of him either. Because that can come back to haunt you and put you in bad habits.
Whoa! Bullock with the reverse. Carolina's in a habit of scoring tonight.
You don't have to convince Reggie Bullock of what your mindset has to be. He's still going hard. It's a nice drive right here, and the spin, the pirouette, and he gets the call.
It's turned into open gym tonight at the Dean Dome.
Well, Reggie Bullock, we talked about one of the best. And that, well, we take a look at James Michael McAdoo right there. Yeah, okay. And there's the pirouette, Reggie Bullock.
Couple of occasions they have done what? They have met Johnson and Kaji and Gamble on the interior. Now
under the basketball, and here's an example. Good two-man game. Stayed a little wider than a label right here. He's just going to take him one-on-one, take him right to the goal, and beat him. And they've been doing that all night.
They're in time now.
The
hang out at the old well in shirt sleeves as the temperature soared to near 70 degrees. Today, it's a different story. This morning, snow greeted residents of Chapel Hill.
19 minutes of play. Played 34 minutes against Duke. He will play 30 minutes or so here today, in my opinion. A deep three-point shooter, an outstanding athlete, and he can score. North Carolina will need scoring against a very stingy Virginia defense.
All right, Eddie, let's take a look. Two schools meet, even though Virginia's only won 6 times here at the Smith Center.
We'll be back.
To North Carolina, we've got some others looking on. Look at that group. There's John Henson. There's Kendall Marshall, Tyler Hansbrough. All in. Double comes quick, right off the pass, Eddie. Nice Johnson with a dunk inside.
Quick twitch, just takes it and splits it and hops up and almost looks like he's on an 8-foot basket for most people. North Carolina, Marcus Page, head up, catches McDonald in transition. It's into the lane, nice penetration for the floater. North Carolina on a great.
Hairston for 3 more.
Wow.
Oh, what a show we got behind the arc for both of these teams.
Wow. That boss.
But look at today. It's canceled there today because you see some snowflakes in there, and the t-shirts that were on yesterday have been replaced by
perimeter to set a screen. and kind of slips out, and Virginia's slow recovering to cover the ball and poor weak side help. Now the post up. Good drive to the basket here, and the good help comes across by McAdoo.
On their second half run.
Well, off to a good start. McAdoo, an easy layup after the ball screen and flare out. North Carolina goes back inside. The double team was a little late, but the weak side rebounding by P.J. Harrison is really getting to the board. And the defense, again, late double teaming McAdoo. McAdoo rather turn and face.
Through the first half, and he stayed on ever since.
Well, that shot right there is deep. Look how quick he gets it off that. That one's much more open for him, but any shot that P.J. Harrison basically can get off, you think is going in. In fact, Steve, he's such a good shooter, I think you've got to live with one or two bad shots a game.
21 points, he stands two away from tying a career high.
Well, I know how to stop him. Offensive rebounding against the Tar Heels, another opportunity. Good job on the offensive boards by North Carolina. Bryce Johnson.
Dark has been a big issue.
Incredible shooting here in the second half, 6 of 9. North Carolina, 12 of 26 overall. That's 36 points in 26 possessions, which is terrific offensive efficiency.
That's allowed them to score more points than any team has scored.
Got it handed to him in the first half on the road in Raleigh. Well, Mr. Hairston now, who is increasingly confident on the offensive end. We had him about a month ago, and I looked at this.
The bounce picked off. Strickland stuffs it. Bullock off the fake, fires up a long one. That one he drains, the three-pointer to tie it. Way downtown, Bullock, yes. Has never beaten Roy's Tar Heels here in Blue Heaven. Will today be the day in the rivalry's latest chapter? North Carolina Miami has finally lost in conference play. The Canes are now 13-1. Bump there and swatted away by Hubert. Well, he's gone from starter to bench player. His minutes are way down, but he didn't look like it affected him there.
Well, this is his ability. He's not going to help you much on the offensive end, but length, athleticism, timing, shot blocking, transition. The crowd just getting a look at it. Oh, it's a white jersey. McAdoo is down, and then Mr.
They got to get it in the air. Harrison usually the man.
Like P.J. Harrison as a player, and with the spacing and the kind of shooting, Bullock's right next to him. You don't push up in time. That's with length and size.
Here's McAdoo at the fifth, then he steps it. And the reverse.
Carolina on a 7-0 run, and James Michael McAdoo at least once a game is going to okey-doke you folks. He's going to turnovers resulting in 16 points off of those. I mean, that's just a poor pass that Dexter Strickland takes to the other end. Nice job defensively by Hairston to release contact and get it to his running mate Bullock. And on the other,
but it did get to him. Here's Hairston. NC State trying to strike. Purvis, and a block from behind by James Michael McAdoo. A terrific play
is drastically different. Look at the sprint by James Michael McAdoo.
Shot clock down to 12. Here's Page. Got it. He hits the three. Boy, McAdoo got up high, spins and gets it.
James Michael McAdoo to be a better offensive rebounder. He has the athleticism necessary.
He drives hard to his right on Leslie. And another version of toughness.
Well, thank you for the backup, Mr. Hairston, because there's physical and mental toughness on both ends. This is a hard drive through contact using the window. That takes some upper body strength and a little best rebounder.
Bullock straight on. Yes. A three. McDonald gives it up. Page waiting now. Firing. 17 rebounds. Bullock straight on. Page trying to take the baseline, and a foul, and he made it! .501 left, Wood with the personal foul. Could turn into a three-point play for Marcus Page.
This young man was over his head the last time these two teams played. In the second half, he has been dynamite. A three, the adjustment air, 8 points all in the second half. How about that, young man?
Page up high for Bullock. Won't wait, he fires. Got it.
Knows what this rivalry means. You think that man is fired up? Forget the cold. And this young man was flat outplayed, out of his depth on the road in Raleigh. Not here in Chapel Hill. Threes, drives, passes. This is a play everybody runs. Bullock took a foul to the head, I thought, still made the jumper in Carolina.
Shot clock at five. He's taking it himself. He scoops it and gets it.
And Roy wanted him to pick up the pace. It probably occurred a little bit slower than Roy wanted, but how about the degree of difficulty? Nice handle by the young man. You think his philosophy over the years has been big man inside.
He made five threes earlier this year against Virginia in a win at home.
Wow, and a deep three by P.J. Hairston.
In the ACC, but you cannot leave North Carolina.
Bullock with the rebound. James Michael McAdoo and one.
Milton Jennings contested the three-point line. But then he ran down the other end. Look at Jennings. He contested. He's going down the other end. You got to get the rebound first. Second chance points for North Carolina.
Get your game on.
Ice water pouring through my veins. I'd watch. We're changing the
get your game on.
They've been highly efficient on offense. 12 assists on 15 baskets. You have to find them. They got three-point shooters everywhere. Marcus Paige only 30%, but they went under on the handoff. This Bullock, the team's leading three-point shooter, 43%, and P.J. Hairston knocking it down at 41% in the eighth. The steal by Bullock. That was the first pass. North Carolina wants to get out in transition. They're looking for steal. What do I got to do to get the block up? This is where they're best, when the game gets faster. When you score the ball at home with pace, it gets the crowd engaged.
Hairston from downtown, Butter. P.J. Hairston, a 38% three-point shooter. Snooze bar on the full court press.
But Clemson falling asleep. That's too easy for North Carolina.
On a chilly 41-degree day in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, packed house, 22,000 making their way into the Dean Dome, which features count of six national championship banners. It is an ACC matchup. The Seminoles of Florida, Strickland, P.J. Hairston from downtown. He's an excellent three-point shooter. Call of a deflection, but it was not touched.
And here's why it's so difficult to cover North Carolina. Now they can spread you out with all these shooters.
McAdoo off the steal. McAdoo with the stuff, yes. And a count. A foul on Shannon.
You saw that look from Leonard Hamilton to Shannon, saying, what are you doing? The rust, not only in handling the ball, but committing the silly foul. McAdoo with the and one. Every cut is contested.
The alley-oop for McAdoo. Beautiful timing on that pass on the drive. And it's put down again by McAdoo.
This is a club, we mentioned it, Marv. They've struggled all season to kind of find themselves, but I think they've done it here in the last couple of weeks. Look at this execution, the backdoor lob, Hairston to McAdoo. Tell you what, this is...
Bullock with a deep three. Oh. Yes! Come on. No hesitation by Hairston. 20-3 run, and Florida State will talk it over. P.J. Hairston, 3-for-4 from beyond that three-point line. It's been all Carolina. They're up 35. It's just impossible to figure out. North Carolina up by 16. Into the half, back it into the rim, and scores at the buzzer. Well, check it out, but it appears he was able to get that shot off on top. 17 points on 8 of 10 shooting for James Michael McAdoo.
Just horrendous transition defense. Why cover out all the way at half court when there's only a second on the clock? Florida State should have been packed in that loss.
And Snell lost the handle. And here comes Strickland to put it down. A the steal. It's all Dexter Strickland.
Back in Chapel Hill, a 15-point lead for the Tar Heels. How about the first half for James Michael McAdoo? 8 of 10 shooting, 17 points. He's done it all defensively, the steal, the transition basket. How about the presence of mind to get that ball out of his hand just before the halftime buzzer? Marv, you know, it is not...
Beautiful Carolina Basketball Museum, which is located adjacent to the Smith Center here on campus and is part of the memorabilia.
I could just picture Michael talking with his family after reading the letter.
That counts on the foul. Bullock on the recovery after Strickland's shot went short.
Marv, I've been in this building several times, and this is a great crowd. I think this Carolina crowd really enjoys watching this team, and it's been a process for this club.
With the three.
At 9 for 15. Watch how many of these are basically uncontested for Bullock, who's 4 for 7 from beyond the arc. And Carolina has just been executing, taking care of the ball, and scoring in transition. And
North Carolina gets the ball up court in a hurry.
The lob! Bryce Johnson from Reggie Bullock. Leading to a timeout, 2 minutes, 2 seconds to play. It is all Carolina. They're up 75-54.
Young man who suffered a knee injury a year ago, excellent role player off the bench, giving Roy Williams a lift. 17 points a game, and tonight he's just pretty much picking up where he left off, driving to the rim with power. The post-up game, very solid against guards inside, and we know he can stretch it with the jump shot, both from inside the arc and behind the line. And I think this is the most important play of the first half for North Carolina. Watch this, Bullock out in front. Hairston knows where Page is. Big three to end the half.
The Roy lead on the road. Deep one for Hairston. Run right now for North Carolina, looking to extend the winning streak to 6. To do the kick to the corner. It's a 3 for Reggie Bullock.
You got a couple weeks ago. Watch the spacing inside, then the kick to the corner. You got to guard 4 guys out there. Opens up room for
Page with a shot fake. And a kick. Strickland can't get it off. Page for 3. Huge shot for the Heels. McAdoo. And 1 for James Michael McAdoo. Maybe his biggest play of the night.
We talked about the fact that when you go 4 on the perimeter, McAdoo, even against size, is going to get a chance to operate one-on-1 in there. Really not bad defense by Len, but McAdoo does a good job of forcing the contact and using the left hand.
Chapel Hill, North Carolina! Get out of your seat and make some noise, and let's meet your University of North Carolina Tar Heels, coached by Roy Williams! At forward, a 6'7 sophomore from Norfolk, Virginia, number 43, James Michael McAdoo. At forward, a 6'7 junior from Kinston, North Carolina, number 35, Reggie Bullock. At guard, a 6'6 sophomore from Greensboro, North Carolina, number 15, P.J. Hairston. Number 22, Frank Kenner. And at guard, a 6'3 senior from Rahway, New Jersey, number 1, Dexter Strickland.
There he is. You know, guys, the old wine and cheese crowd allegations, those don't seem to apply so much.